Texas, home of the Baylor Bears and McLean Stadium. Boats lining the Brazos as the Baylor line is ready to welcome the Bears onto the field. There's nothing quite like a great rivalry matchup in college football. The bitterness, the intensity, the lifetime of memories that will come as a result of what we're about to see in this one. As we see a squad from the Big 12, the TCU Horned Frogs, taking on another team from the Big 12 in an interconference matchup, the Baylor Bears. For EA Sports College Football, Reese Davis with you alongside David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Time to get this game started. The Horned Frogs will boot it away to start the game. Coming out with it, it's Cameron. And the ball is loose on the return. The kicking team's got it and they take the ball right back. Short fields make successful offenses just what they want here. Throws to the wideout. That completion will take them inside the 10 to the 9-yard line.
Love the accuracy on that curl throw by the quarterback, putting it right in the numbers, right in the breadbasket of his wide receiver.
And the Horned Frogs want to move quickly. Looking for a man. It's Hoover. He caught it. He's down at the one, and they almost had the touchdown pass on that one.
I love offenses and quarterbacks that are willing to take the easy stuff. Take those easy throws that are guaranteed to get positive yards. Yeah, I'm going to take big shots down the field, too. But don't forget, it's easier to pick up second and five, third and five, than it is when we start getting those long yardage situations.
And makes the grab in the end zone. Touchdown, TCU! And it feels good to land that first big punch against a rival, doesn't it?
No doubt. In a game like this, too, you just want to be executing it at a high level early. So, David, that's got to feel great getting on the board first.
And settles everyone down. All the nerves, all the emotion of this rivalry game. Now everybody can kind of settle in because you know you already got a touchdown on the board.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point makes it 7-0. Quick strike offense on that three-play scoring drive. It was capped off by a 1-yard touchdown pass. The kickoff team takes the field to boot this one away. And they desperately wanted to attempt a return, but decided not to. Instead, they'll take the touchback. So the Baylor Bears offense will try to get something started with their first possession. Here are our impact players for this game, and it goes beyond executing an assignment to make an impact in the game.
Yeah, obviously we were talking to both coaching staffs this week, and we asked them who needs to step up and play well. They immediately pointed to these guys right here. They are the key for their respective teams.
Yeah, and they don't always show up in the box score, but these are the guys that are the leaders. These are the guys getting everybody organized and have to play well for their team to succeed.
Perfect play call for that big gain to open the drive. Now here they come on first and 10. They'll give it to him again. And maybe they want to try somewhere else because there is nothing doing in the middle of this defense. The biggest lie college football coaches tell is nameless, faceless opponent. David, game like this, you know their name and you know their face.
You know them well, and it does mean just a little bit more because it's bragging rights. Like, the rivalries matter so much. All throughout the year, all the fans talking about this game in particular, that's why it means more, and that's why these players will be jacked out of their minds.
You know, the short passing game is a great go-to weapon for any offensive coordinator in the first quarter because it's reliable, obviously, but it also allows you to see how the defense is going to react and play you. So for coordinators, this can really open up the rest of your playbook for the rest of the game.
On third and long, he has to throw for it. Fires to the wideout. A strike downfield. And this defense was flailing as he weaved his way and got down to the 26.
And the quarterback knew exactly where he wanted to go with the football, had time, spins the ball deep. Nice job by this offense, understanding what the defense is giving them and creating the explosive play.
The Bears are on the move. on the move. It's Reese. And a good, solid pickup there before the defense knocks him down.
And that's the problem with blitzing on defense. You live by the blitz, you die by the blitz. Defense dialed up the pressure, but the offense had a better play call. They ran it away from the blitz, and that's why they were able to be successful.
9-yard pickup on first down, and now they can take a shot on second and short. Keep it on the ground. He rumbles all the way down to the 2-yard line. He gave him a little bit of everything on that one.
And already this guy is leaving his mark on this game. Opening drive, back-to-back runs where he's found a way to get positive yards. He was able to pick up the first on that last carry. They should keep feeding him the football. The more success they have, it's going to open up the play action game.
They'll use the running game on first and goal. Into the end zone he goes. Touchdown, Bears!
Mano a mano, the offensive line gets it done, driving the defense back, creating an easy lane for that running back.
He'll try to tack on one more. Splits the uprights. That is an efficient drive. 7 plays, 75 yards. And finished the deal with the short touchdown run from the 2. All tied up and just about set to kick it away. From inside the 10-yard line, he'll bring it back. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. TCU has it back, and the Horned Frogs go on offense. David, they'd love to do what they did last time and put this one in the end zone.
You ain't lying. They did a great job. The offense was clicking. Everything went well. Palmer, they executed and got the touchdown.
And they really were in a nice rhythm as well. And I'd love to see that here on the next drive, too. Just keep doing what you're doing. Everything seems to be working, and you seem to have this defense on their heels.
After the quarterback and receiver failed to hook up, they'll try it again on second down. Off play action. He's going to let one fly down the middle. And that's going to be incomplete, going for broke on second down, but third down's coming up. We anticipate this one being much tighter than the last time these two met when it was a blowout, David.
And here's the thing. You got an opportunity right now. You got the football early in this game to show you. This is going to be more of the same, Palmer.
Well, we talked to both coaching staffs and players, and they're all very aware of what happened the last time these two teams played. So expect everybody's A game today. Reese, you're right. We expect this one to be a lot tighter.
And he gets it to the 45-yard line, and that'll be a first down.
That's what's so scary about this offense. They've got guys in the perimeter that can change the game in one single play, and you saw it right there. Too much speed on the perimeter to create that explosive play.
The Horned Frogs will hustle to the line. Off the play fake on first down to throw. Got rid of it just in time. Hit hard just as he released it on first down and just couldn't get it to the receiver.
Give that guy a lot of credit, man. He was able to somehow avoid that sack, but nobody open downfield throws it away.
Line getting set on second down. Looking to throw, it's Hoover. He's going to let one fly down the middle. And he makes the catch inside the 15. Defense makes a stop, but the chains move, and it's first and goal from the 8.
What a beautiful throw and catch on this play, and I love the job the receiver did tracking the ball in the air. Nice job of locating the throw and then hauling it in.
With the run on first and goal. Not much room. He gets one down to the 7. Defense rose up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a second and long coming. He's looking to throw. They go up top to get it down to the 5-yard line as they try to pay off this drive.
Well, we knew coming into this game, this offense was going to try and get this receiver involved and get him involved early. So here they are just finding an easy completion. It's not a touchdown, but they just want to get this guy lathered up and get him into a rhythm.
Third and goal, where you separate the wheat from the chaff. Pocket starts to collapse. And the heat gets there. And they get him down at the 14-yard line.
Great timing by the defense there. Obviously, the offense has the ball in the red zone, and you're trying to create a negative play to back them up. They do that with the sack, and if they're now going to try a field goal, it's going to be a little more work for the kicker.
And they'll send out the kicker to try a field goal. Absolutely nothing settled. Deadlocked after one period of play as we have a look at the stats. We've got a good one going here and looking forward to keeping those vibes going here in the second quarter. They're happy enough to try to take the points as the field goal unit heads out. He splits the uprights and puts three on the board. And with that field goal, they now have the lead. After putting three on the board, the kickoff unit ready to go. Fielded in the end zone. It's Baldwin. I know he thinks he can house every return, but sometimes you just have to take a knee as he stopped at the 14. From the gun, the running back looking for room. Navigates that mass of bodies and gets four out to the 17.
You know, it's so important for offenses to want to keep third downs manageable. The way you do that is by having success like that, running the football on first down.
Solid pickup of four on first down. It's second and six. Back to throw, it's Robertson. He's right on target. And it's a catch, but he's got enough for the first down.
Nice completion here to this wide receiver, and you're going to see this receiver line up in different spots all over the field all game long. Defense has got to keep their eye on where this guy is because they know he's a big part of this offense's success.
First and 10 from their own 24-yard line. They go to the counter. Out across the 30 mark, down at the 35 after the 10-yard gain.
First down. Physicality wins football games. Being able to run the football and create balance. And right here, just chews up another first down, gives you another chance to maybe continue to run the football.
And I feel like this guy, too, is just an explosive play waiting to happen. His vision, his quickness, and he's got a burst. If you give this guy just a crease, he's going to hit it. And right now, he's doing some damage on this defense. Nice job by the defense there, taking all throws away from the quarterback. He had nowhere to put that football in the field to play, so that ball obviously had to go out of bounds.
After the incompletion, it's second down. Gives it to the back on the draw. And they try the middle of this stout defense, and they rise to the challenge.
Well, they try to go with draw. They didn't catch the defense blitzing, so it wasn't a great look anyway. But up front, they just got beat regardless. And that back, David, had nowhere to go.
He had nowhere to go. But those offensive linemen, you got to set and you got to invite those defensive linemen up the field and kind of push them by. And you could tell they didn't do that. They didn't create any holes. There was really nowhere for him to go. You got to give him that first little hole, and then maybe he can make a move. So the offensive line needs to do a better job.
Listen, I know this running back is shifty. I know he's really good in the open field, but that's just asking too much of him at this point. Third and long situation. He wasn't going to be able to make that extra guy miss trying to get that first down.
And the Bears will punt it away on fourth down. And the punt hits at the 8 and goes into the end zone for the touchback. TCU will send its offense back onto the field. And to settle for the chip shot field goal last time, Jesse, they'd love for this one to pay off bigger.
Yeah, it just comes down to...
He's loose! And they'll finally bring him down after he rips off a huge play.
I'll tell you, the defense is going to have to do a much better job containing these outside run plays. They better be able to funnel the football back to the middle of the field, because this guy with his speed can kill you like he did on that outside run play there to the left.
And the Horned Frogs want to crank the tempo. He'll do it himself. They pick up half of it. It'll be 2nd and 5.
And this option attack can lull you to sleep sometimes. I mean, just so many things they can do off of it, and you just got to play responsibility, responsibility, and you got to get them on the ground and make tackles. And that was a good job limiting the damage on that play with a nice tackle.
They get to the line quickly. Wide receiver coming across in motion. Fires deep toward the end zone. Had it in his hands for the score and let it fall to the turf. It'll be 3rd down.
Wow, you usually don't get that wide open in the end zone. If that ball comes in like that, that's a play the receiver has just got to be able to make for his team.
Ball's at the 47. They're looking at a 3rd down and short. To the air, it's Hoover. Unloads it left. Another incompletion on 3rd down.
Yeah, and in 3rd and short, it's a great place to be for an offense. You've got the whole playbook available, and they choose to pass. And the defense did a really good job playing the pass. And 4th down now, it's decision time for you.
The Horned Frogs will send out the punt unit. First punt of the day, and he'd love to lock them up close to their goal line. And the punt hits ground at the 2 and goes into the end zone. He just missed, pinning them right in the shadow of the goalpost. It'll come out to the 20. Pulls it in. It's Hawkins.
Man, that quarterback knew that was a tiny window to throw into, and he just showed off his cannon of an arm.
Completion a little short of the sticks. It's 2nd down. He leaves it with his back. Knocked down at the 31 after a gain of 5.
Well, the offense knew what they needed to get that 1st down, so they dial up the running play, and they get just enough to keep the drive alive.
And they'll line up from the 31 on 1st down. Might as well give it to him again. 1-step wrap, 2-step squeeze. This junior knows how to get him on the ground. The clock has reached the 2-minute mark, and they have a chance to at least cut into this lead before the break. Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on 2nd down. He's looking to throw. Got it in the middle. It's Hawkins. And he'll have enough for the 1st down at the 42.
Well, the defense did a nice job taking everything away down the field, but once the drag route was caught, they just couldn't rally to the ball carrier in time to make a tackle, and as a result, new set of downs.
The clock is not their friend. Got to get everybody to the line quickly. Back to pass, it's Robertson. Still looking, on the move. Trying to escape and get it himself. He makes the stop at the 48. That'll be enough for a 1st down and a pickup of 10.
You can tell this is a pass play. He has his eyes down the field. He's looking to throw the football. But how nice is it when you got a guy like this that can scramble and go get you a 1st down? Just really hard to stop from a defensive perspective.
The Bears in the hurry up. He's going to pass. And this will be incomplete. A big hit there forces 2nd down.
You know, it's difficult for QB sometimes when you're throwing to your running backs because they're not receivers. You really got to be perfect with the ball placement. You got to make that a catchable throw. A little bit too tough for the RB on that one.
And after the incompletion on first down, this offense looking at second down. Was the pass. Throws for the tight end. Just a bit of a misfire there as they can't make the connection.
Well, give the defense credit because they're forcing this quarterback to throw into very small windows under duress.
They line up, and it is a long way to the sticks from here. They'll move the running back to try to force the defense to adjust. They're bringing heat. And the defense will corral the quarterback, and down he goes at midfield. The pocket broke down, and the quarterback had to take the sack.
Really impressed by this pass rush, Reese. Just guys winning their individual battles one-on-one up front. They're able to get to the quarterback.
And the Bears will punt this one away. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. And the ball hits at the 3 and gets into the end zone. It'll be a touchback. TCU has it back and the Horned Frogs go on offense. Coming up, he lets it fly. And that one falls incomplete. They tried to go over the top on first down. Second down coming up.
And guys, if I'm on offense, I am staying aggressive. I know you didn't connect there, but make sure you keep testing this defense because even if you complete one of those throws, that could be the game-breaking play.
Still at their own 20 after that last incompletion. It's second and 10. Looking for room. It's Cook. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. There's a timeout on the field. Tight game here late in the first half.
And that seemed a little off from the start, didn't it?
That was a big-time play, and it was off from the start because of the play he made.
And I don't think it would have mattered who was playing running back. There was absolutely nowhere to go.
And he's not going to get there. The defense stands tall and makes the stop. They'll use a timeout right before halftime. Maybe time for one or two more plays. And the Horned Frogs decide to punt it away. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. On the return, it's Cameron. This guy is a daring punt return man. He's not going to settle for the fair catch. A solid return gets a little bit of ground for the offense. That's the end of the second quarter. That means it's time to join Kevin in our halftime update.
Fellas, what an environment there today. All the animosity and flat-out hatred that comes with a good old-fashioned rivalry game on display in that first half. And it's been said football is a game of inches. And guess what? Based on the comparison between third down conversion rate today and the average yard per play, how can you argue that? I mean, the low-lying fruit is to look at some of the explosive plays we've seen and panic. But really, this game is going to come down to which team is more efficient when they have the ball and how they play when it matters most. That said, let's get back to the field and our guys in the booth to see who comes out on top of this rivalry contest.
TCU will send its offense back onto the field. And in a low-scoring game like this one, David, every possession is magnified.
And I think more than anything, it just gets frustrating. And you got to put that behind you. You got to see what this defense has been doing to be so successful. Palmer, now use it against them.
Yeah, David, I think for a play caller, this is tough, right? It's like you have to have the perfect play on just to get a first down. In these types of games, I think you're just trying to get guys out in space, see if a dude can break a tackle. Maybe that generates an explosive play, and it breaks this trend.
Hard-hitting tackle.
And quarterbacks love running backs who can catch the ball because they're stat patterns. That's an easy throw for this quarterback to make. He's just letting his running back do all the work. Get him the football out in space and let the magic happen.
The Horned Frogs are in the hurry up. To the ground to try to pick up the first. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 3.
And I think that might be an example of the running back maybe trying to do a little bit too much. Everybody wants to try to bounce the ball outside and hit the home run, but in college football at this level, you just need to do a better job taking what the defense gives you.
And the Horned Frogs will call on their punt team. Bringing it back, it's Cameron. Coverage team gets the job done, and they'll mark him down at the 38-yard line. Baylor has it back, and here comes the Bear offense. The sledding has been tough. Scores have been at a premium, Jesse, and every possession seems like it could switch the momentum of the game.
Yeah, Reese, for this offense, just feels like they just haven't been as physical. And for this offensive coordinator, David, he's having to go deep into the playbook just to try to generate a first down.
Well, and the good thing is there's not a ton of game pressure because the other side's not scoring either. But if you can find that one thing, that get that one positive play, and then maybe you get those juices going and something can start to build.
Not a whole lot of progress made there on the short run.
This offensive line better figure out a plan for this D tackle. He is tough to block with one guy. You might want to start double teaming him. He's going to be a problem moving forward. You saw all of his ability on that last play.
Here they come, facing third and long from the 40. To the air, it's Robertson. Shoots it to the left. Complete downfield. And a big gain there. He's knocked down immediately at the 45.
Well, look, that wasn't a touchdown. That was a massive play for this offense. They needed some momentum. They needed to find a rhythm, and what better way than converting on third down? Awesome job by the quarterback getting through his progression.
Fast motion from the offense. Going up top on first down. Got it behind the line. It's Hawkins.
One of the things that makes this guy so dangerous is how good he is after the catch. If he's got any space around him, he's able to burst. He's able to make people miss and get extra yards for his offense. You saw it right there.
Trying to get a rhythm in the passing game. Now on second down. Wide receiver shows motion. On second down, he's looking downfield. Got a man, it's Hawkins. They get him on the ground, but it's a first down. They've done a really good job creating the matchups they want out of the spot.
Yeah, dude, get that guy matched up on a linebacker. That guy matched up on a safety. Keep him away from the corners by putting him in the slot. Get him the football, let him make plays.
The Bears are flying down the field. And he's brought down after a nice game. And the Bears come to the line with a fresh set of downs. From the red zone, looking for a receiver. Bought a little time, lets it go. Almost had the completion, just missed it.
Well, I don't know if the big fella got freaked out because he was so wide open on that play, but that is a catch he has got to make for his quarterback.
Offense gets set for second down. After the incompletion, they go back up top. On the move, he fires. And his throw is incomplete.
And that was good defense again. And unfortunately, we've been saying that all game long. Really, really good defense. Or, listen, you can spin on the other side. This offense has really been bad.
This drive was clicking along, but after a couple of misfires, threatening to stall out on third and 10. Looking to throw, it's Robertson. Flushed out of the pocket. And Shore tackling there to keep him from getting to the first down marker. The Bears will try to convert on fourth down. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. Gets it out quickly. They'll get him stopped just short of the end zone, but they're in business here with a first down.
That's a great example of the receiver knowing exactly where the first down marker is. He got the depth he needed to get, so once he was able to make the catch, he already knew he had it. Now, a fresh set of downs.
And the Bears will try to punch it in on first and goal. With that, they've got the lead here in the second half. Man, did he show some hops for that one.
Some serious vertical right there. I tell you what, everybody in front of you, hey, I'll go by air if I need to. Good job getting in the air, getting the touchdown.
Lining up to add another. And with the extra point, they're up 14-10. That touchdown drive covered 61 yards. And they capped it off with a 1-yard plunge. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. Looking for an alley from inside his own 10. Finds just enough space to cross the 25. Let's mark it at the 27-yard line. TCU has it back, and the Horned Frogs go on offense. Their drive chart is starting to look a little monotonous. Punt, 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 David.
And their defense is starting to get a little frustrated, too. They just keep putting me back on the field, possession after possession. Jesse, this offense needs to get their heads out of their you-know-whats.
The punter's on the sideline with the oxygen mask right now. He's been playing so much. He's not used to this. This offense, they just got to stay on the field. They've got to put a drive together and get some balance going, running and throwing the ball.
From the shotgun, they'll run it. Good, solid run on that one as he gets it up to the 33-yard line.
And a nice job by the running back, finding space, getting downhill, making the good run. Great job finishing with his pads.
The Horned Frogs headed quickly to the line. Looking to throw, it's Hoover. Grabs it in the middle. And they'll finally get him down after a terrific pickup. That's the end of the quarter, and it's Baylor holding the edge. They've built a cushion. They've got a nice lead. Now the task is finish the deal as you take a look at the third quarter stats. Not only is the scoreboard on their side, but so too is time as we open the fourth. Power football with the run.
How about the job by this defense today? They knew what they were getting into. A really good running back. We talked to him this week. It was the main focus point of this offense, stopping the run game, stopping the run game. Boy, have they showed up and showed out and answered that challenge.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and 9. The pull and throw off the RPO. Just what they were looking for, and he's got him set up in business at the 35 with a first down.
And a big key on that throw to the slot receiver, guys, is putting the ball out in front. The location of the throw is what helped that guy get extra yards after the catch.
And the Horned Frogs look to keep this drive humming. Coming out on first down with the play fake. Using the quick game. And that defense pushing him out of bounds after a short game.
My old coach said, you'll never go broke taking a profit. Take what's there, take the positive yards, and never complain.
Now on second down. From the gun, the running back has it. They get him on the ground after he gets enough to move the sticks.
Well, I know this is an offensive line that has a ton of pride, and they want to come out each and every game and really impose their will on the D-line. They got just enough push there on that run play to pick up the first.
The Horned Frogs will line it up on first and 10. Use the play fake, now to throw. working that left side now. Touchdown, Horned Frogs! And they grab the advantage, taking the lead here in the fourth.
I think one of the most underrated things we talk about with a QB is timing. Being able to get the ball out of his hands to his receiver where he can continue to catch the football and run with it. Nice pitch, nice catch, nice play in the fourth quarter when you needed it for this team to take the lead.
This one's big to make sure they can't beat you with a field goal. He's got it, and the lead is up to a field goal. So it's a 73-yard touchdown drive, and they finish it off with a touchdown toss from the 23. The kickoff team out there set to boot it away. He'll bring it out. It's Cameron. Gets it across the 20 to the 21, and not quite what he would have picked up just taking the touchback. Here comes the Baylor offense back onto the field. On that last drive, defense had no idea what was happening, run or pass, and it wound up in the end zone, Jesse.
Yeah, you saw the experience in this offense that last drive, too, on that touchdown. Everybody on the same page. These guys have repped these plays over and over in practice and in games, and it's working.
Yeah, so I got to find a way to disrupt it. I got to find a way to maybe be more aggressive, maybe blitz, mess up this rhythm they got going.
They've got a first and 10 at the 34. He'll keep it himself. Just sort of a relentless run, getting everything that was available to him, and they'll mark him down at the 40.
This defense really has their hands full, guys. They got to play with great eye discipline because they don't know who's going to be keeping the football in the run game. And that time, you saw the QB. He was able to kind of skirt his way to get some positive yards.
To throw, it's Robertson. Makes the grab over the middle. They'll get him stopped at the 45, but it's a big 15-yard pickup and a first down.
Yeah, this is simple pitch and catch. Quarterback and wide receiver have done this 4 million times in the offseason. He catches, waits for him to take a couple steps, boom, fires it right on his chest. They can complete this probably with their eyes closed. They've ran this route so many times together.
Got his man quickly. They make the stop, but not before they do their work up top and pick up a first down.
I'll tell you what, that's great execution between the QB and receiver. They look like they could execute that throw in their sleep. Quarterback took his steps, threw it on time. Great route by the receiver. Nice job securing the catch.
All the way down at the 33-yard line, it's first and 10. He wants to throw, looking to buy time. The quarterback scrambled around, but the defense able to scramble him and turn it into a sack.
And come on now, O-line, you got to take care of your quarterback. He takes care of you. He's the one who takes you to meals. He's the one that gets you those NIL deals. Everything happens through your quarterback. You got to keep him upright. That is your number one priority.
A first down sack can be a drive killer. Now it's second and 13. He's looking to throw. And the pass is incomplete, jarred loose by the hit.
And that's where quarterbacks, you know, they got to be very assertive. They got to believe what they see and really pull the trigger. But the longer they wait and they get off rhythm or off timing, a lot of times it ends up in incomplete passes.
If they tried the field goal from here, it would be 53 yards. They'd love to help the kicker out on third down. Going up top and trying to put points on the board on third down. Now they're staring at fourth down.
And after that incompletion on third and long, because of where they are in the field and because they have a narrow lead, you'd expect this team to just go ahead, kick the field goal, and take the points.
So on fourth down, here comes the field goal kicker in a huge spot. No good. And after the miss, they're still down by a field goal. TCU will send its offense back onto the field. We'll see how aggressive this defense is with just a few minutes to play. Unloads to the wideout. All kinds of room to throw that one in there. A huge gain on that one before he ran out of bounds, and he has the first down.
Well, how about the offense setting that play up? We've seen earlier in the game a couple shorter throws. They're just trying to suck those safeties closer to the line of scrimmage, anticipating that they would get an opportunity to take a shot. They called the perfect play at the perfect time right there.
They'll try to keep this clock moving on the ground. And he does a really nice job finding open space and making a good gain before the stop is made.
No mystery on that play. With the lead, we are going to run the ball. You know it's coming, and we are running right at you, right into the teeth of the defense, and they're still able to get a nice game.
And the Horned Frogs racing to the line in the hurry up. We've reached the two-minute warning in this offense, trying to milk this clock and keep time on their side. Here comes the offense on second down. Give to the back. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. Quick timeout called by the defense, stopping the clock to save as much time as possible for their offense. This third down play might be the last chance for this defense to stay in the game. To the air, it's Hoover. Complete to the left. And he's knocked down immediately, but they're in the red zone at the 14. Timeout called there by the defense, desperate to get the ball back and save as much time as possible. The Horned Frogs have it with a first and 10. Using his legs, it's Cook. Really nice stop there from this senior leader. Defense uses a timeout quickly, trying to get that ball back and preserve time for their offense. Second down coming up on this red zone opportunity. Leaves it with the back. And they're able to shove him to the turf as they stop him for a short gain.
And not a surprise by this offense, right? This is a game management type situation. I want to run the football. I want to run the clock. The clock is my friend with the lead late in the fourth quarter, inside of a minute. I'm going to keep this ground game going and make you have to look at that clock continue to tick.
On third and long, trying to have a big completion here. And the incomplete pass will bring up fourth down.
And with that incompletion, it now sets up a very interesting decision for the head coach, right? You've got a narrow lead. You kick the field goal now, you force the opponent to have to at least score a touchdown to retake the lead. But you can also seize a lot of momentum if you get it here on fourth and short. If you're able to score a touchdown, this is a completely different game.
And this one splits the uprights. So after the last drive ended with a field goal, the kickoff team out there to send it away. He'll bring it back from inside his five. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. Baylor has it back, and here comes the Bear offense. To the air, it's Robertson. Right down the middle. And he got a hand in there, knocks it away incomplete.
Really nice job there by the safety back in the middle of the field. You see his range and the speed. He's able to close on the ball and then knock it away. Nice play.
No time to waste here. They've got to get set and pick up chunk yardage. Misfired on the last play. They'll go back to the air. Fires on the move. He makes the catch. Gets it to the 42-yard line, and that's a first down.
And I love the awareness by the wide receiver on that play, because I'm not sure that route was supposed to be that deep. You got to wonder if the receiver decided maybe to adjust the route a little bit to make sure that he got the first down.
And they'll spike the ball to try to save as much time as they can. They've got to move quickly here. Still a chance, but they've got to force the ball down the field. On second down, looking again to throw. Fires to the wideout. Got his man downfield. Really nice job there by both guys, the throw and the catch, to work that defense and get the first down.
Nice job by the receiver on the in route there. And how about the speed? After he made his break, he was able to actually separate a little bit from the DB, helping out his QB on that one.
Clock is still running, and they have to get everybody lined up. Double time, hustling to the line. They spike it to stop the clock. Let's see what they've got on second down. Looking to pass, it's Robertson. He hurls one deep down the left side. It is incomplete, and now there are 4 seconds remaining.
It just took a shot down the field, didn't get it, so you've got time for one more play. Everybody thinking Hail Mary right now. I know the odds don't say you're going to come up with it, but man, we have seen crazy things happen in college football.
They were on the move, but 2 straight incompletions had them staring at 3rd and 10. He's not afraid to go deep. It's incomplete, and they had a chance in the end zone, and he just couldn't come up with it, and that's going to do it.